This is the Pines River in Rumney Marsh in Revere and Saugus, Massachusetts. Located 5 miles north of Boston, this 1,650-acre estuary supports abundant fish, shellfish, birds, and wildlife. Between 1967 and 1969, as part of plans for the Interstate 95 project, a 2.4-mile-long embankment was constructed across the marsh, filling 120 acres of wetlands and relocating the Pines River to a rock-armored channel. The fill for the highway created a barrier to water flow across the marsh. Salt marsh restoration involving the removal of the abandoned highway fill has been occurring here since the 1990s. In 2015, an additional 8 acres of fill removal occurred in Saugus. Seen here on opposite sides of an older restoration project, these areas will take years for nature to fully reclaim. All of the salt marsh restoration projects at the embankment have been required to retain a flood protection berm, based on the belief that the embankment lessens coastal flooding. Studies have shown that spring high tides, which occur at the new and full moon each month, are reduced by 1/2 to almost 1 foot on the upstream side of the embankment. The embankment, however, offers little protection during coastal storms due to the prolonged duration of high water, which continues to fill the estuary. The embankment restriction would then delay drainage after a flood. Spring tides ensure a healthy salt marsh, but these reduced tides have created conditions favorable to invasive species like Phragmites and perennial pepperweed that have replaced normal salt marsh vegetation along many edges of the marsh. Significant erosion is occurring at this tree-lined embankment section in Saugus, where the east branch of the Pines River was cut off by the embankment. This erosion is adversely affecting tidal flooding and drainage. The eroded soils from the embankment can be seen at low tide as sandbars and ripples in the creek and constructed ditch. It may be possible to remove portions of the embankment and restore the altered drainage patterns, since the embankment does not provide the level of flood protection previously believed. Removing the embankment would restore a more natural tidal hydrology to the marsh, which would help control invasive species and improve habitat for fish and wildlife. By restoring the severed creek connections across the embankment, tidal flow, drainage, and fish access to the marsh will be improved. If the embankment is not removed, continued erosion at this location is a certainty. The physical footprint of the retained portions of the highway embankment is the single largest impact to the marsh, which may still be restorable. Considering the secondary impact to 444 acres of marsh, restoration of marsh hydrology would have significant benefits. These are the homes most at risk of flooding and coastal storms. The neighborhood was in part created by filling the marsh. The salt marsh behind the homes has been colonized by Phragmites and cattails due to a restrictive 18-inch culvert, which is not adequate for tidal flow or marsh drainage. Notice the grayer color vegetation along this side of the marsh near the power line crossing. This area is vegetated with Phragmites, which has replaced normal salt marsh grasses. Restoration of about 30 acres of marsh at the northern end of the embankment at Ballard Street has been planned since a tide gate broke in 1990. Leakage from a makeshift tide gate has restored a salt marsh creek to a healthier state, an improvement over the past conditions. Small minnows in the creek eat mosquito larvae, providing biological control of mosquitoes, and juvenile winter flounder have been seen in the creek. This long excavation of the embankment was created in 2015. The sand and gravel was used for a beach nourishment project in Winthrop. Wetland restoration at this location is complicated. A 1996 plan required the construction of 2 new tide gates near Ballard Street. A subsequent 2015 plan requires 5 or 6 tide gates and a relocation of drainage from the Saugus to the Pines River at Bristow Street. Since runoff behind tide gates cannot drain during high tides, a storage area must be provided to handle the runoff. The proposed relocation of drainage and tidal control to the Pines River seen in the background, installation of a one-foot culvert in the creek at Ballard Street, and use of rubber duckbill-type tide gates has raised concerns that will be evaluated during permit review for the project. Finding a solution to balance flood control needs with marsh restoration opportunities at Rumney Marsh is a challenge.